Holly decides to take a look around her childhood home, and she is flooded with emotion. Everywhere she looks, she catches glimpses of the past, and she finds some old Christmas boxes, her mom's favorite, and she drags them into her old bedroom, and she rummages through them, just relishing each memory. Well, eventually, she falls asleep and dreams all night of Christmas's past and the joy her mother found in everything. And in the morning, she wakes up filled with a renewed sense of connection. Goodness is rewarded. Hope is guaranteed. Laughter builds strong bones. Right will intercede. Things you've said, I often find I need. Indeed, I see the world through your eyes. What's black and white is colorized. The knowledge you most dearly prized, I'm eager to implore. You said that tonight, but it's this little Christmas tree ornament, and on it it says, "Lisa wishes you infinite joy," and I do. I wish all of you infinite joy this holiday season and yawns for life. So anyways, here's one for everybody. Don't fight. All right, now back to the movie. Okay, so filled with the spirit of her mother, Holly decides to use the decorations that she found to spruce the place up a little. And she is struggling to hang some mistletoe when Nick appears. And he's like, "Oh, were you expecting me? Get it, mistletoe?" Well, Holly is thrilled to see him, and he volunteers to help. And so she immediately puts him to work. She explains that she's decorating the place for Christmas one last time, and that her mother would have wanted it that way. Here we go. Out the holly, put up the tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stocking, I may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now. For we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols at the spinet. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. It hasn't snowed a single flurry, but say the dear, we're in a hurry. So climb down the chimney, put up the brightest string of lights I've ever seen. Slice up the fruitcake, it's time we hung some tinsel on that evergreen bough.
Christmas.
My mom and my dad, my sister and brothers, would pack ourselves into the car in hopes we'd agree on the perfect tree for the house where I grew up at Christmas. It was so long ago, the lights on the tree sat by the window and watched it snow. It was simple and beautiful and easier than I'd give anything to make me feel that way again. Oh, I wish I could feel like I felt before in the house where I grew up at Christmas. I wish I could see through those eyes once more when it all was new at Christmas. The moment I feel like it's lost forever, you look at me the way you always do. Everything's new when I'm here with you. Like those feelings I had with my mom and my dad in the house where I grew up at
Christmas. Guess what? Holly decides that she doesn't want to sell the farm.
Yes! It is too important to her and to the town.
Yes! And all she wants for Christmas is to stay in Silver Bells and to be with Nick.
Yes!
I don't want a lot for Christmas. Come true.
Polly gathers all her things, and she and Nick head to the train station to find Green. You remember Green? Well, he's waiting at the train station for the train back to the big city. But Polly tells Green that she's had a change of heart and that she no longer wants to sell her family's property. And yeah, right? I know, it's so good. But Green says, that it's too late. You signed the paperwork on the train, right? On the train, and a deal's a deal. So if I were you, I'd get on this train back to the city. There's nothing for you here in Silver Bells. And the train whistle blows. All aboard? Well, Polly, she is forced to make a decision. And, well, she tells Nick that, well, maybe Green's right. You know, without the farm, there's nothing for me in Silver Bells. And she steps on the train. What? And she steps on the train, and I mean, clearly, Nick is devastated, but all he can manage to say is goodbye. And the train pulls away from the station, and she watches as Nick slowly fades into the distance. Well, back in the big city, Polly tries to resume her normal life. But everywhere she looks, she's reminded of Silver Bells with her Nick. It's coming on Christmas. They're cutting down the trees. They're putting up reindeer and singing songs of joy and peace. Oh, I wish I had a river I could skate. Thank you.
Well, it's almost Christmas when Holly sees that she has a text from Nick. What? And it says, the Christmas tree farm has been saved, and that he wants her to go to Silver Bells right away. Well, I mean, of course, she books the first train ticket back to Silver Bells. Oh my God, and she spends the whole day getting ready. I mean, she had to pack cute outfits. Okay, well, when she gets there, it is already Christmas Eve. But when she looks around, I mean, everything looks different, and everyone she sees welcomes her home and calls her by name. And I mean, everything is festive and joyous, and Oh, right, that's right. Remember, she turned right down Santa Claus Lane? Yeah. Right, see what I did there? Yeah. And she joins a huge Christmas party already underway at the Christmas tree farm. I mean, she didn't even know there were this many people in Silver Bells. You know? Golly! Well, at the party, she overhears that it was Nick who saved the Christmas tree farm. He bought it back from the mega store, and the whole town is celebrating. Christmas is back in Silver Bells, and Holly wants to be back with Nick. Every time I look around this room, my eyes get tender, falling when I confess, nothing but you makes sense. Memories fill my heart and I can barely keep my tears from falling. Oh, I want your love. Do you ever think of us? Is it too late to open up? I'm dying to say, oh, how I love you. You're walking towards me now. Push my pride aside. When I close my eyes, it's just you that that they build in silver bells. And the children they end up having. And they all live happily ever after. The end. Oh, and it snows. Don't you just love a happy ending? I mean, right? Isn't that what we all want? To know that even though life can get a little rough, that a happy ending is possible. That is why there are hundreds of new Christmas movies every year. We need them. We need these stories. I mean, we need to believe that people can be kind and that miracles can happen and that we can all be loved. So bring it, Hallmark. Bring it, Lifetime and Netflix. Yeah, your stories of love and hope are a gift to us all. And that is what Christmas means to me. Whatever movie is on tonight, because it's going to be a gem, and you already know what happens.